My little boy, I'd like to look at this, please.
Sure, it's fine too, mister. I got it from my father.
Your father's? Really? I'll take it.
You're getting it for practically nothing.
I'm getting it for exactly nothing.
I mean, it's only 10 bucks.
I think you should give it to me.
I'll come.
But don't you remember me? I'm your father.
Hello, Mike. This is my husband. This is Mike Marshall, a Cub Scout I told you about. We had quite a long talk this afternoon.
My wife made a mistake. I had no intention of giving the suit away, so I'm taking it back.
It ain't yours anymore.
It was mine, and now it's mine again.
She gave it to me.
I will not argue the point with you. I'm taking it.
You take it without paying, and I'll call the cops.
Bob, please. As a matter of fact, he's perfectly right. It isn't yours anymore, unless you pay for it.
I have no intention of buying back my own garments. Let go of my coat!
It ain't your coat!
Is anything wrong?
No, nothing, thank you. $10, Mike?
Thank you.
You shouldn't have done that, Helen.
Please, dear, let's go quickly.
All in good time. Now we can go. His father's suit. How did that little lyre ever get into the Boy Scouts?
That hat's practically brand new, mister. Only $2. Got it from my brother.
What do you want us to do with a bad man, Red Eagle?
Yeah, Red Eagle, tell us.
Well, first we stop his car and then capture him.
Then what do we do with him?
That's time to escape, and then burn him.
Yeah.
Yeah, and burn him good.
That won't work.
Who said that?
I did.
Oh, you?
Huh.
Why won't it work?
Somebody will stop us the minute we light a fire. They always do.
Yeah, that's right. What do you say, Red Eagle?
Well, that's time to escape and scalp him. That's it.
Me for real?
Sure.
Can't scallop anybody unless you do a war dance first.
Oh, well, just a minute. Now, remember that. You two braves.
Can't scallop anybody unless you do a war dance first.
He's right, Red Eagle.
Well, we can scalp him, can't we?
You have to do a war dance first.
Do you know a war dance, Red Eagle?
Sure. How's that?
That's no good. You gotta sing when you do it.
Oh, you gotta sing.
Sort of stuck.
Are you a burglar?
Heavens, no. The steward locked me and I was waiting for a friend.
Why didn't you ring for him?
I didn't think of it. Isn't that silly?
If you were a burglar and I helped you escape...
Please help me before somebody comes along.
I'm thinking. All right, I'll help you. I'll help you for two reasons.
Never mind the reasons, just help me.
The first reason is I'm too young to be sent to jail. The second reason is, you've got a lot of animal magnetism. Hey, look, someone's coming.
Oh, dear, what'll I do?
Quick, hold this around your neck tight.
Good evening.
I say... Whatever are you doing up there?
I just wanted to see the view from here. It's better.
Quite so. Are you feeling well, my dear?
Yes, thank you ever so. Except for being so cold. I must have caught a chill.
What say we go and get a spot of sherry?
Oh, no, I can't.
Well, sherry's the best thing if a cold is coming on.
Honest, I couldn't.
Well, you do look a bit flushed, my dear. Let me feel your pulse.
No, please do.
There's no cause for alarm, my dear. It's purely medical. Well, there's no fever at any rate.
I'm all right. I'm fine.
Such a little flowery hand.
Please put that back.
So sweet. So tiny. And yet it can hold a human heart.
Stop that.
I beg your pardon?
Well, laryngitis, I guess.
There's no doubt about it.
Piggy, I better have some of that sherry. Will you get me some?
I fly on the wings of Mercury.
Just hurry up.
All right, my dear.
How can you stand that doddering old wolf? Can't you see his intentions are not honorable?
For heaven's sakes, get me out of here. Help me over here.
Right this way, mister.
Hello, kids.
Hi.
Hi.
Well, why did Mrs. Fulton say to meet her here?
She didn't say.
Was Mr. Fulton there? I mean, at the house.
He could have been.
Oh, that's the reason. I see it now.
Mister, will you play with us? We need a nice tall man to play Maypole.
Well, I'm sorry, but I haven't time now.
Don't you like children?
Of course I like children.
Why are you mean to them, then?
I'm not mean to them.
Don't you want to make us happy?
Of course I do.
Then play Maypole.
All right, I'll play Maypole, will you? If you'll go tell Mrs. Fulton I'm here.
Okay. You're very nice to play Maypole with us. Now you step right back here against this tree and hold this up real high.
All right.
That's fine. Come on!
I thought you were going to tell Mrs. Fulton.
Can't I watch for a minute?
No, you promised you'd do it if I'd play Maypole.
What was it I promised to tell her?
You tell her that I'm here. Now, why don't you... Hey, wait a minute. You're getting this too tight. I can't move.
You can come out now, Red Eagle.
I'd like to see Mr. Murdoch.
Good afternoon, madam. At your service.
Then yes. You, Mr. Murdoch, are responsible for my son, Richard.
Oh, how do you do, Mrs. Murdoch? Nice to know you.
I am not Mrs. Murdoch, and I'm Mrs. John Stilton.
Oh.
As publisher of the Bat Lady, you are responsible for my son's condition.
Condition?
And as I am chairman of the Second Elementary School District, I'm going to file a petition against your comic book. Before I do, however, I think you ought to have the pleasure of my son Richard's company while I go shopping. To observe for yourself the effect your horror literature has on undeveloped minds.
Yes, but madam... As a mother, aren't you just a little bit worried about leaving your undeveloped mind here?
Your mother's the one to be worried.
Well, Richard, pleased to make your acquaintance. Pleased to offer you my hand. Bessie, what floor is a nurse on?
The second, right below Dr. Stevens' office.
Thank you. Spring cheese.
Who's that?
This is Richard Stilton. His mother left him here for developing. Don't get too close, though. He may be poisonous.
Boy, he's cute. Well, Richard, what can I do to entertain you?
Not a thing. You're too old for me, Mophead. Is this a dagger?
No, it's a letter opener. It is too sharp for little boys to play with.
Who wants to play with it?
Oh, 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 oh.
Hey, don't... Oh.
Richard! There's no way to behave. But the Bat Lady wouldn't like that.
Who cares about the Bat Lady? She's too tame. She stinks. No blood. I like blood. You touch me and I'll throw this jug of acid in your eyes. I'll mobilize. Look, Niagara Falls. Why don't you two go on a honeymoon? I'll bring the barrel.
Hey, look! Oh, Jiggers, the car!